The basic function of switches is to connect devices to the network. Of course, they can do far more, but every other feature they have is to support connecting devices. Primarily, switches work at layer 2. When we think about layer 2, we think about things like MAC addresses, Ethernet frames, and VLANs. A lot of modern switches support some layer 3 functions. That means IP addressing, routing, and that sort of thing. For this section of the series, we're going to focus our attention on layer 2. We commonly use Ethernet protocols in our networks. Each Ethernet frame has a source MAC address and a destination MAC address. Ethernet, and layer 2 in general, is used to deliver frames from one hop to the next. This means that with each hop, the source and destination MAC will be updated. The source will be the device that's sending, and the destination will be the next hop along the path. This process is called frame rewrite. Switches don't count as hops in this sense. That is, they don't update the source and destination MAC addresses of each frame that passes through them. So what are switches for? Connectivity. All devices need to be connected to each other in some way. But we can't literally connect every device to every other device. Imagine how many cables we would need. Instead, the switch uses a process called frame switching. Instead of connecting devices directly to each other, devices connect to switches. As you can see, this is so much simpler. When a frame arrives at a switch, the switch decides which link or interface to send the frame out of. This makes sure that the frame gets to the correct destination. The next question is, how does a switch know which link to send the frame on? It does this by learning the MAC addresses of connected devices and the interfaces they are connected to. These details are stored in the MAC address table. When a frame arrives at a switch port, the switch takes a look at the destination MAC address. Remember that this is in the Ethernet header. It looks for this MAC address in the MAC address table. Here, it finds the port that the MAC address belongs to. It then forwards the frame out of this port. We should ask ourselves, what happens if the MAC address we're looking for is not in the MAC table? This means that the switch hasn't learned about this MAC yet. In this case, it will flood the frame out of all ports. That means a lot of devices will get that frame. Most will ignore it as it's not meant for them. The correct device will send its reply, which the switch will see. The switch can then learn which interface this device is connected to and add the entry to the MAC address table for next time. Do you want to see what a real MAC address table looks like? From the CLI, we can use the command show MAC address table. Here we can see all the MAC addresses that the switch knows about, and the port that should be used to reach them. Entries don't stay in here forever though. Once an entry is learned, a timer starts. If more traffic involving that MAC address is seen, then the timer resets. But if the timer expires, the entry is removed from the table. This is one way the switch keeps the table fresh. For example, we might have a laptop that we disconnect from one port and then connect to another port. If the MAC address table didn't clean up after itself, traffic might get sent out the wrong interface. If you're planning on taking the CCNA exam, we have a few extra resources to get you ready. These include study notes, quizzes, flashcards, transcripts, and the command line summaries. Check the video description to get a link to each of these resources. Usually quiz explanations are for members of the site. However, I've made all the quizzes in this video available to everyone, so you can see if you like them.